Okay, so today we will learn about the sequence spaces, which are non-linear spaces. So we will learn three spaces, namely the set of all convergent sequences of complex number, the vector space, linear space of all convergent sequences of complex number, which converges to zero. And one non-linear space is all the sequences which have only finitely many non-zero components. So all these three forms a non-linear space under the suitable norms, but only first two are the Banach spaces. The third one is an example which is not a Banach space. That means not every non-linear space is a Banach spaces, right? So we will see the first example, that is denoted by C naught naught, C double naught. Okay. So let me present my PDF. What I shared. Okay, so this is the first example. So we will learn first of all the structure of this structure of linear spaces. Okay, fine. Yes. So the first example is C, that is the set of all convergent sequences of complex numbers. Symbolically, C is equal to set of all sequences such that limit n tends to infinity xn exist. So how the linear space operations are defined? For x and y in C, the addition of these two elements is defined in this way, and the scalar multiplication is defined in this way. Then it is easy to observe that this C forms a vector space with these two operations. First one is y, because x plus y belongs to C. Why it belongs? Because you know the property of the limit. Limit of sum of two sequences is the same as limit of first sequence plus limit of second sequence. Similarly, for scalar multiplication, if you take limit of alpha xn, this is the same as alpha times limit xn. And because limit xn exists, limit yn exists, so these are also, this also exists and this also exists. Okay? So C is closed with respect to addition of vectors and scalar multiplication. So other properties of vector space axiom, linear space axiom, is easy to verify. So you can verify that C is a linear space. Similarly, C naught, that is the all the sequences which converges to zero, is also a linear space. C double naught, set of all those sequences which have only finitely non-zero components. That means if x is any sequence in C double naught, then there exists some natural number nx such that all the terms after nx is zero. That is, up to x1, x2, x3, xnx may not be zero, but after that, all the terms are zero. This means we also call C double naught is the sequence space in which all the sequences are eventually zero. That means after finite number of terms, all the terms are G. Okay, so this is one remark. Clearly, any sequence which is in C double naught is also in C naught, right? Because eventually this is zero, so limit is also zero. And which is convergent to zero means convergent, and every convergent sequence is bounded. So this proper inclusion means there is an element which is converges to zero, but not in C double naught. So this inclusion is proper. Okay. Another inclusion, that is the subspaces. You can say C double naught is a subspace of C naught. C naught is a subspace of C. And I know what is the subspace means, vector subspace. So LP is contained in LP plus epsilon. This is important. If epsilon is greater than zero, then P bigger than or equal to 1 less than infinity, LP, that is the sequence of all complex number which are P summable, is contained, properly contained in LP plus epsilon. Now you understand what meaning of LP plus epsilon. And this is C naught, this is contained C, and this is element. Okay. So for this, how to prove? This is not so obvious. Okay. So how to prove? Suppose X belongs to LP. And because x belongs to LP, this means the series is the sum of this series is finite because they are p-summable. What does it mean? It means mod xn is less than 1 for each n bigger than or equal to n. You know, if the sequence is convergent, then its un terms, nth terms tends to 0. So obviously, after a fixed n, this terms is less than epsilon, whatever epsilon you choose. You choose 1, so mod xn is less than 1. And putting both the power epsilon, this is less than 1 for each n bigger than or equal to n. Now, n is equal to 1 to infinity mod xn to the power p plus epsilon can be written as like this, up to n terms here, and after n terms we can write like this. Okay, so what you have, this is equal to this, that's fine, but this quantity is going to be less than this. Why? Because mod xn to the power epsilon is less than 1, so putting in place of this just 1 makes it bigger, so this is bigger. Now compare with this one. This term is sum of non-negative real numbers, finite sum of non-negative real numbers, so it is finite. This is infinite series. Compare with this one. This is finite. Here are some n terms are missing, so still it is finite. So finite plus finite is finite. So what you proved? You proved that this sum is actually finite. So x belongs to LP plus epsilon. So is that clear to everyone or not? Just reply in chat box. Is it okay? Okay, fine. Okay, so let us proceed. These are the example. C is a Banach space. C naught is a Banach space. But C double naught is not a Banach space, right? Under any norm, whatever norm you define on C double naught, it is not a Banach space. Whenever say that it is not a Banach space, that means there are some specified norm under the norm. But you will see, whatever the norm you will define here, it is not a Banach space. So basically, the P norm and the infinity norm. Okay. So whenever we say that C double naught is not a Banach space, means they are not a Banach spaces under the infinite norm or any P norm. So let us see the first example. So we will skip very some terms, some steps we will skip because already we have seen the process. Okay. So let us see the first one. C is a Banach space. So how to prove it is a Banach space? Already you know this is a non-linear space under the norm this one, under the sup norm, under the infinite norm. Then this is a non-linear space. And again the process is same because you are going to see the completeness, going to prove the completeness of C. Let XR be a Cauchy sequence where XR is like this. Then for epsilon greater than 0, there is a positive integer n such that whenever r and s are bigger than or equal to n, you have the difference between the distance between these two terms is less than epsilon. By definition of this norm, this is less than epsilon. And from one, it follows that you see first, so you can write here r comma s bigger than or equal to n is implies mod xjr minus xj s is less than epsilon for each j. It is not true only for the one j, it is true for each fixed j. So what does it mean? It means the sequence this is a Cauchy sequence of complex numbers, and because C is complete, so this Cauchy sequence is convergent to some complex number, say zj. So limit r tends to infinity xjr is zj. So using these limits we will form a vector. We will form a vector, okay? Z is equal to Z1, Z2, Zj, and so on. So now we will show that this Z belongs to C, that is, this Z itself is a convergent sequence. Moreover, this XR sequence converges to Z under the infinite norm, okay? So how to prove this infinite norm? Okay, so how to prove this? Okay, we saw that Z belongs to C and XR converges to Z in C. From 1, it follows that for each J bigger than or equal to 1, R comma S bigger than or equal to N implies that this one. From first, because the supremum is less than epsilon, what does it mean? Each and every term is less than epsilon, right? So we can write in this. Now, this is true, whatever R S is bigger than or equal to N you take, right? And this is a sequence. If you fix R, this is a sequence in S, which is less than epsilon always. It is bounded above always. So what does it mean? In the limiting case also, if you take S tends to infinity, it will be less than epsilon. And because taking limit may be equal to epsilon also. So that's why taking limit S tends to infinity in 2 and using this concept, using this limit, we have R bigger than or equal to N implies this one. Because XJS tends to ZJ. So we used ZJ here. And this is the third. And this is true not only for one J, it is true for every J bigger than or equal to. Okay, so this is now the property of sequence space. This XR, this is a Cauchy sequence. Because each XR belongs to C. Each XR means X1, X2, X3, these are the vectors in C. Means in itself, these are the sequences. So in particular, if you put R is equal to N, Xn is X1n, X2n, Xjn, and so on, is a Cauchy sequence, right? Why it is a Cauchy sequence? Because it is convergent. So that's why in field of complex number or the field of real number, right? It is a, either you take the Cauchy sequence or you take the convergent sequence. Both have the same meaning, okay? Because they are complete. So it is a Cauchy sequence. And because it's a Cauchy sequence, so by Cauchiness property, there is some M such that this property holds, right? For given epsilon greater than. Okay, what is your problem? Our problem is to prove that ZJ itself, this ZJ sequence, that is Z sequence, itself is a convergent sequence or Cauchy sequence. Because this is a sequence in C, right? This is the sequence of complex numbers. So either you prove it is a Cauchy sequence, or you prove it is a convergent. Both have the same meaning. So let us prove that this is a Cauchy sequence. So now we have Zi minus Zj is equal to, you manage these terms, what we have done? We have just subtracted Xjn and added Xjn. Then again, we have subtracted minus Xin and added Xin. So this will managed. So ultimately you have Zj minus Zi or Zi minus Zj. By triangle inequality, this plus this and plus this. And you know, this is less than epsilon by 3. You see here, right? If R is bigger than or equal to N. So in particular, if you put N here, Xjn minus Zj. So Xjn minus Zj less than epsilon or equal to epsilon. This is less than epsilon. This is less than epsilon. You see here. And this is again less than or equal to epsilon. So this is less than or equal to, this is less than or equal to, but due to this strict inequality, you have the strict inequality here. And this is 3 epsilon. So you might be thinking, why I am writing here 3 epsilon? Here should be less than epsilon. It does not matter, because you can write here epsilon by 3, epsilon by 3, epsilon by 3, it becomes epsilon. So because epsilon is arbitrary, it does not matter either you write 3 epsilon or you write 1000 epsilon. If it is less than 1000 epsilon, you take just replace epsilon by 1000, it becomes epsilon. So there is no problem. You have the same meaning. So what it proves? It proves that Zi minus Zj is less than 3 epsilon for all ij bigger than or equal to. Therefore, this is a Cauchy sequence of complex number. And since it is complete, it is convergent sequence. Therefore, this Z belongs to small c. Okay. Now again, from third, we have R is bigger than or equal to N. What is third? Let us observe here. This is third. R bigger than or equal to N, XJR minus ZJ is less than or equal to epsilon. And this is going to be true for every J bigger than or equal to 1. What does it mean? For 1, for 2, for 3. In case of supremum also, it is true. So that's why considering here supremum is also true. and that is the infinite form. So we have proved XR converges to Z in C, means Z is a vector in C, and this convergence is under the infinite norm. So this proves is a nonsense. I hope it is clear to everyone. Okay? Okay, to everyone, write in a chat box, please. Good. Okay, so let us proceed to the second example. C naught is a Banach space. So the idea is the same. As you prove the C is a Banach space, you can prove C naught is a Banach space. Only the change is that you just you have to show that the sequence, the limit Z converges to zero. So you will see this what I have done. I have done here this difference. Mod Zj is less than 2 epsilon. So this means this is 0. So this belongs to C naught. And remaining are same. So I'm not going into this this one. So you just do it yourself. Yeah, this example is important to us because this is the first example which are going to see as a nonlinear space, but it is not a complete nonlinear space. That is, this is not a Banach space. That is, we are going to prove C double naught under P norm is not a Banach space for any P, that is P lies between 1 to infinity. So first let us prove for P bigger than or equal to 1 and less than infinity. Okay, and suppose this XR is a sequence. XR is a vector like this, 1 by 2, 1 by 2 square, 1 by 2 to the power j, and 1 by 2 to the power r. After that every term is 0. Then clearly, XR belongs to C naught for every r bigger than or equal to 1. What does it mean? What is the meaning of x1? X1 means 1 by 2, and after that every term is 0. X2 means 1 by 2, 1 by 2 square, after that every term is 0. Similarly, x3 means up to 3 term, 1 by 2, 1 by 2 square, 1 by 2 cube, and after that every term is 0. So this is a particular term, arith term of the sequence. Okay. So our idea is we will show that this is a Cauchy sequence, but it does not converge to any vector in C double naught. Okay, we can prove that there is a some Cauchy sequence which does not converge to a vector in C double naught. That means this is not a Banach space, because a Banach space is a nonlinear space in which every Cauchy sequence converges to a vector in that space. We are going to show that this XR is a Cauchy sequence, but it does not converge to any vector in C double. Is okay? Okay. So for R less than S, let us take the norm of XR minus XS. So this is, see, XR means, see, R is less than S, right? So XS means there will be some term X to 1 by 2, 1 by 2 to the power R plus 1, 1 by 2 to the power R plus 2, and so on. 1 by 2 to the power s. When taking the difference, 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 0, 1 by 2 square, 0, so up to 1 by 2 to the power r, 0. So you have j is equal to r plus 1 to s, 1 by 2 to the power j, power p, whole to the power 1 by 2. Just r plus 1, so 1 by 2 to the power r plus 1, power p, 1 by 2 to the power r plus 2, power p, 1 by 2 to the power s, power p, 1 by 2. Is okay? Fine. So this will be 1 by 2 to the power jp, 1 by p, and of course this is less than or equal to j is equal to r plus 1 to infinity terms. So you know this is a geometric series, and you know the sum of this. You can take 1 by 2 to the power p r plus 1 common, then you have 1 plus 1 by 2 to the power 2 to the power, yeah, 2 to the power p, then you have 1 upon 2 to the power 2p, then you have 1 upon 2 to the power 3p, and so on, right? So this is an easy idea. It is easy to prove that this is going to happen, right? So this is less than or equal to j is equal to r plus 1 to infinity terms, and this is the sum of infinite geometric series. And because here this term is nothing to going to change, because p is fixed here, but r is going to change. So taking r tends to infinity, this whole quantity goes to 0, so 0 into something goes to 0. So what you proved? Taking R tends to infinity means S also going to infinity, right? Means we are taking R and S bigger and bigger, we are going to see that this difference is smaller and smaller, and a limiting case goes to 0. So that is the Cauchiness property. Okay, so therefore this sequence is a Cauchy sequence in C double naught. Okay, so what we have proved? We have proved that you have a Cauchy sequence like this. So this sequence is a Cauchy sequence. Be so that this does not converge to a vector in C double naught. On contrary, let us suppose that this XR converges to a vector Z in C double naught. Z in C double naught means after some finite number of terms, all the JJ is 0. That is, it may be any number, maybe 100, 1000, billion, trillion. After that, it must be 0. If it is in C double naught, because by the definition, C double naught is a space of sequences which are eventually 0. Okay, so now this XR converges to Z in C double naught. What does it mean? It means XR minus Z under P norm goes to 0 as R tends to infinity. And by definition, this is J is equal to 1 to infinity, XJR minus ZJ power P, 1 by P goes to 0 as R tends to infinity. What does it mean? Because each term is here non-negative, this non-negative, each non-negative term must goes to 0, right? You are adding non-negative term, non-negative, non-negative term, and the whole sum is 0. What does it mean? It means each and every term must goes to 0. So therefore, this XJR minus ZGJ goes to 0, goes to 0 as R tends to infinity. Therefore, XJR converges to GJ is equal to 1 by 2 to the power J by definition, because this XJR means 1 by 2 to the power R, right? 1 by 2 to the power R. So, XJR. So, XJR means what you have? Sorry, let me define this. Yeah. So XJR means if you consider X1, so X1 is 1 by 2, X2 will be 1 by 2 square and so on. So here it is J, so it must be 1 by 2 to the power J. So it converges to this, means this must be 1 by 2 to the power J. So this, because converges to 1 by 2 to the power J, and you know the sequence, the limit of a sequence is unique. So if it is converges to ZJ also, but you know that XJR converges to 1 by 2 to the power J, right? Because see, this is XR. If you are increasing R, means the non-zero terms is going to increase. 1 by 2, 1 by 2 square, 1 by 2 to the power, 1 by 2 to the power R, 1 by 2 to the power 100, 1 by 2 to the power 1000, 1 by 2 to the power billion, trillion, etc. Right? So if R tends to infinity, right? So ZJ, XJR converges to 1 by 2 to the power J in limiting case, okay? And also it converges to ZJ. So limit cannot be different, so it must be same. What does it mean? It means Z1 is 1 by 2, G2 is 1 by 2 to the power 2, G3 is 1 by 2 to the power 3, GJ is 1 by 2 to the power J. And this is true for every J. What does it mean? It means the term GJ is not going to be 0. For all j bigger than or equal to 1, means all the terms here are non-zero. It means z is not in C double naught, and this is a contradiction. Hence, it does not converge in C double naught. Therefore, this is not a Banach space. Any problem? Any doubt here? Okay, so let us prove the last one. This C double naught under infinite term is also not a Banach space, right? So the idea is same. You have considered the same sequence. Now we will prove that this is a Cauchy sequence under the infinite norm also. So XR minus XS means supremum of, because of two R terms going to be zero, right? After that, 1 by 2 to the power R plus 1, 1 by 2 to the power R plus 2, and so on, 1 by 2 to the power S. Because R plus 1 is smaller, R plus 2 is bigger, S is more bigger. So this term is going to be supremum. That is the maximum of the S minus R elements, okay? So 1 by 2 to the power R plus 1. This is the supremum. And this goes to 0 as R tends to infinity. This means this is a Cauchy sequence in C double naught. And again, it is the same idea. There is the same idea. If possible, suppose this converges to Z. It means XR minus Z converges to 0. This means supremum converges to 0. This means XJR converges to ZJ. But XJR converges to 1 by 2 to the power J. What does it mean? It means ZJ is 1 by 2 to the power J for all J. Therefore, Z is not in C double. So, in this way, we have done and we have seen the example of two non-linear spaces from sequence space. One example from sequence space which is not a Banach space, okay? And also, we have proved that this C double naught is not a Banach space under any norm, that is P norm or infinite norm, okay? In the next lecture, we will learn some more Banach spaces which are from function spaces, and we will see some further stuff in the area, okay? Okay, thank you so much. Any problem, any doubt?